Nightingale's first USA-sourced LNG cargo reaches Dabhol terminal. Ethical values matters at the end of the day. Students should not think only about scoring ranks, says Railway Minister Piyush Goyal. And state observes Good Friday today. The day is most pious day for Christians. Thank you, Mark. Hi, and welcome to MetroScan from Mumbai. I'm Shama Mishra. Let's see the news in detail. After crude oil, India today began importing natural gas from the US with the first shipment of LNG under long-term contract, with state-owned GAIL reaching at Dabhol terminal in Konkan region. This marks a new beginning of the Indo-USA energy partnership and trade. Union Petroleum Minister Dharmendra Pradhan, who was present on the occasion, said that the government is working towards making India a gas-based economy. He further said that a shift towards a gas-based economy would require augmenting domestic production as well as imports. He added that the adequate investments in natural gas infrastructure is the focus area for the government. Railway Minister Piyush Goyal said teachers are those who mold the life of students. Apart from parents and students, teachers should also be felicitated, he added. The minister was speaking at the students' felicitation program of J.K. Shah classes organized today in Mumbai. Encouraging the students, Goyal said that rank does not matter, it is what you learn that matters. Goyal added, care, concern and commitment are the values that teachers inculcate in a student's life to make them a better person in the life. The state is observing Good Friday today, which, as per the Christian calendar, remains the most pious day commemorating the crucifixion of Jesus Christ. Christians in the state attended church services, prayer, and also observed fasting. In Mumbai, the day was observed with processions. Various other parts of the state as well are observing this day with different programs. In order to provide self-employment opportunities to people in Naxal-affected areas, as well as to bring the surrendered Naxals in the mainstream, a special civic action program 2017-18 was organized at Aheri town in Garchiroli district of the state. Central Reserve Police Force 9 gave training as well as certificates of MSCIT to 40 unemployed people in the area. Also, in order to provide self-employment to women in the area, sewing machines were also distributed amongst the ladies. 20 youth were given civil construction training and certificate of the course. The main purpose of the Civic Action Program is to give right direction and provide proper guidance to Naxal-affected people in the area.
अंतर्गत गढ़चिरौली डिस्ट्रिक्ट में अति नक्सल ग्रस्त क्षेत्र होने के नाते यहाँ पर आदिवासियों और जो नक्सल से सरेंडर है उनके परिवारों को रोजी आर्थिक रूप से सबल बनाने के लिए केंद्रीय रिजर्व पुलिस बल डायरेक्टरेट एवं भारत सरकार के द्वारा निर्देश दिया गया सिविक एक्शन के अंतर्गत हम लोग आज सिलाई मशीन के तौर पर प्रशिक्षण देकर को सिलाई मशीन उसको मुहैया करवाए. इसके साथ जो कंप्यूटर्स ट्रेनिंग किए हुए हैं, कंप्यूटर्स ट्रेनिंग वाले को सर्टिफिकेट के साथ में उनको स्टडी किट के साथ उनको आगे रोजगार को शुरुआत करने का एक सुअवसर दिया गया है.
Bangladesh High Commissioner Syed Muazzam Ali said Rohingya class crisis is not only limited to Bangladesh and should be resolved. He added it is both in the interest of Bangladesh and India. The High Commissioner was speaking at a press conference organized in Mumbai to discuss issues of mutual interest with media. He said Prime Minister of Bangladesh is keen about Prime Minister Narendra Modi's neighborhood policy, which is a successful one. He also added that there has been some agreement that has been signed in this regard for the rehabilitation of the refugees. India has done an agreement with Myanmar government. He further said they are trying to put pressure on Myanmar jointly and individually on this issue. Calling the refugee issue a humanitarian crisis in the modern world, Ali said it is better for both India and Bangladesh to see to it that the issue is settled. Ali also emphasized on the 22 MOUs signed between India and Bangladesh, which will be helpful for the bilateral trade between both the countries. All India Gem and Jewelry Today Federation announced Manthan 2018 Gem and Jewelry Conclave by GJC to be held on 5th and 6th April at Sahara Star Hotel in Mumbai. Ashok Meenawala, former chairman, Gem and Jewelry Trade Federation, while addressing the press, said that the main focus of the conclave is on creating job opportunities in the sector. He further said that the conclave will also set the 2025 growth vision for the India's gem and jewelry sector. Meenawala added that the large portion of the industry is in rural areas and the conclave will see a huge participation from rural areas of the state. The two-day conference will see discussions by leading and notable dignitaries from various walks of life, sharing their views on varied topics related to gem and jewelry sector.
जैसे ज्ञान की खोज है, लेकिन सबसे बड़ा उसे भी बड़ा इम्पोर्टेंस हमारे लिए है कि इस इंडस्ट्री में जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ बढ़े, क्योंकि जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज़ हमारी इंडस्ट्री की ज़रूरत भी है, लोगों की भी ज़रूरत है और इस देश की भी ज़रूरत है. और हम ज़रूर हर एक डिस्कशन जो करेंगे उसमें ये सोच बनाएंगे कि इस किस तरह से job opportunities ki ko badhav mil sakta hai.
With an aim to create awareness about women trafficking, the Missing Public Art Project, with support from Sandvik India today, rather recently announced the launch of Missing Game app in 8 languages. The game is world's first that combines the gaming experience with the issues of trafficking and enables it to reach the pan-India audience through its versions in regional languages. Leena Kejriwal, founder of the Missing Public Art Project, further unveiled the Missing Sex Watch survey, which throws light on India's attitude towards consumption of pornography, the level of awareness on how it plays a big role in trafficking, and the social acceptance of the subject. Speaking at the event, Consul General of Sweden in Mumbai, Ulrika Sundberg, said the root cause for human trafficking is poverty, lack of economic opportunities, and absence of social safety nets and redistribution of wealth. She further informed that Sweden was the first country in the world to criminalize the purchase and not the selling of sexual services in 1999.
Trafficking mein and ladkiyon ki figures increase hoti ja rahi hain. Age of girls, ladki log ki average age hoti thi 13 saal ki jab trafficking ho jate the, fir 11 ban gayi, ab 9 hain. साथ में हो जाती हैं, 7-year-olds ट्रैफिक हो जाती हैं, ये सब कितनी भयानक फिगर्स हैं. तो ये सब सुन के सोच के मुझे लगा मैं आर्टिस्ट क्या कर सकती हूँ. इसके लिए मैंने ये पब्लिक आर्ट कैंपेन शुरू किया टू एंगेज द पब्लिक ऑन द इशू ऑफ ट्रैफिकिंग. गेम 2016 में इंग्लिश पायलट निकल चुका था, फिर बंगाली निकला, हिंदी निकली, अब मैं 8 और रूरल वर्नैक्युलर वर्जन्स में निकाल रही हूँ ताकि हम लोग इंडिया के रूट्स में चले जा सकते हैं, हर स्टेट में जाके बात कर सकेंगे. और इंटरनेशनली भी बहुत ज़रूरी है क्योंकि हम लोग का गेम इंटरनेशनली 70 कंट्री प्लस में प्ले हुआ हो चुका है. और हम चाह रहे हैं कि गेम के दौरान, फिर हम लोग का स्टेंसिल प्रोजेक्ट है, इंस्टॉलेशंस के ऊपर हम लोग ऑगमेंटेड रियलिटी यूज़ करेंगे, वीआर भी, वर्चुअल रियलिटी की भी बातें चल रही हैं, एंड सिस्टमैटिक स्कूल अवेयरनेस प्रोग्राम्स.
नाउ वी आर अप टू 39 कंट्रीज हु हैव एक्चुअली क्रिमिनलाइज्ड द बाइंग ऑफ सेक्सुअल सर्विसेज. So our experience is very good from this perspective, and we feel that this is a kind of good example that we'll
be back on Monday evening with more updates from the commercial capital. It's over to Delhi studio. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.